Surakiart Sathirathai, former Thai Deputy Prime Minister and current Chairman of the Asia Peace and Reconciliation Council, is among the foreign members of an advisory body to implement recommendations on Rakhine State. Bangkok Post file photo: Yangon Myanmar has formed an advisory body including foreign and local experts to implement recommendations on the country's conflict-riddled Rakhine State by a commission headed by former UN Secretary General Kofi Annan, according to an announcement published Saturday in state media. Surakiart Sathirathai, former Thai Deputy Prime Minister and current Chairman of the Asia Peace and Reconciliation Council, is among the foreign members, as is veteran former U.S. politician and diplomat Bill Richardson, who currently chairs the Richardson Center for Global Engagement, said the presidential announcement dated Friday. The board has been formed with a mix of 5 foreign and 5 local members with diplomatic, political and academic backgrounds, to advise an existing ministerial-level committee set up to implement the recommendations. Some of the local members were on the Annan Commission, which has already completed its mandate after releasing its recommendations in August. President Htin Kyaw in September formed the Committee on Rakhine State Recommendations with a mandate to bring the rule of law to and create harmony for peaceful coexistence between different communities in Rakhine, and to accelerate the citizenship verification process for stateless Muslims there. Myanmar has been under increasing pressure from the United Nations and the international community to investigate reports of human rights abuses against Rohingya Muslims committed by its security forces at the northern tip of Rakhine, causing more than 620,000 of them to flee to neighboring Bangladesh in recent months. The Rohingya maintain they are indigenous to western Myanmar, while the government considers them to be illegal migrants from Bangladesh and does not even recognize the term Rohingya, referring to them as Bengalis. On December 5, the United Nations Human Rights Council held a special session on the crisis and adopted a resolution in a vote of 33 in favor and 3 against, condemning the alleged rights violations. Myanmar's government reacted Thursday, saying it dissociates itself from the council's resolution but pledged efforts to address the challenges in Rakhine. The Annan Commission, in its 63-page report published on August 24, made 88 recommendations in 16 policy areas, including economic and social development, citizenship, healthcare and cultural cooperation to deal with the sectarian violence. The following day, Rohingya Muslim insurgents attacked security outposts, police stations and an army base in Rakhine, prompting the military to launch clearance operations against the rebels and setting off a wave of violence and the current humanitarian crisis.